And he had said these words unto them, he abode still in Galilee. But when his brethren were gone up, then went he also up into the feast, not openly, but as it were in secret. Then the Jews saw him at the feast and said, Where is he? There was much murmuring among the people concerning him, for some said, He is a good man. Others said, Nay, but he deceiveth the people. Howbeit, no man spake openly of him for fear of the Jews. Now, about the midst of the feast, Jesus went up into the temple and taught. And the Jews marveled, saying, How knoweth this man letters, having never learned? Man, I want to use that just for a text tonight. Having letters, but yet never learned. Amen. We find in the Scriptures tonight, amen, Jesus, He knew exactly when His time was going to transpire, that He was going to go to the cross. Amen. And He knew in this particular place that it wasn't quite time.
Right.
Amen. But He began to teach and He began to talk tell the people things that they know that an ignorant or an unlearned person would not know.
Amen.
Amen. We find in the Scriptures that Jesus was going about. He was doing miracles. He was doing many different things. And amen. The Bible says, and we may read on into it here in a minute, that the Bible speaks about the Messiah, the Christ. Amen. That He... they was looking for the Messiah. They was looking for the Christ child. They was looking for the anointed of God to show up on the scene. Amen. And to, according to what I can read and what I understand, the Jews was in anticipation of the Messiah. Amen. I look around today and I look at the worldly system and I look at the things that's going on in the world in the Middle East. They're still looking for that Messiah.
Amen.
But amen, a lot of times we don't understand, amen, that Jesus, He came. This time of year, we're getting ready to go upon the season that they call Christmas. Amen, a lot of people's taking Christ out of Christmas. Amen, they don't want nothing to do with the birth of Christ. They don't want nothing to do with the life of Christ. And they don't want nothing to do with the crucifixion of Christ. Amen, but we find in the Word of God, amen, that Jesus was standing for what was right. He came in a righteous and a holy way.
Amen,
and the Jews, amen, the ones that was in, you might say, the Pharisees, the Sadducees, the religious sect of that day, Brother Jimmy, they didn't want the Messiah. They wanted a Messiah that they could choose.
Amen,
and you can look into the Scriptures and see when God give Israel the right to choose a king in the first place. They chose somebody that they wanted instead of somebody that God really wanted.
Yeah.
Amen. And it's the same way in the world that we live in today. Amen. People don't want the righteousness. They don't want the holiness. They don't want the true God. Amen. But they want a false God. They want something, amen, that that will please their flesh.
Amen, brother.
Amen, but I believe in the virgin birth. Amen, I believe that Jesus was born. I believe that He did live, that He did die. Amen, and that He did give us remission of sins.
Amen.
Amen. And I believe there was a purpose in His life. How many believe there's a purpose in your life?
Yeah.
Amen, but there was a purpose in Jesus' life. Amen, there was a purpose in Him coming into this world. Amen, and I think of the song that one of the bluegrass singers sings, that God still saves old sinners like me.
Yeah.
Amen, that's the reason He come into the world, Brother Duke.
Yeah.
He come into the world to save sinners. Amen, He just didn't come into the world to receive gifts. Amen. I was at a thrift store the other day. I seen a little sign hanging on the walls talking about the three, instead of talking about the three wise women or the three wise men, it was talking about the three, if it would have been women, amen, they wouldn't have showed up late. Amen. They would have done all these different things. I can't quote it the way the little sign said, but they wouldn't have showed up late. Amen. They'd have been right on time. Amen. But you know, a lot of times, we look at the things about Christmas and so forth. Amen. The Bible says, now if you want to get into the Word of God, the Bible says this. Amen. It says when they had found Jesus, when they sought Jesus, amen, when they found him, the Bible says, according to what I can understand, he was about 2 years old and he was in a house. He wasn't in the manger when the ones from the east found him, but he was in the house. According to the book of Luke, he was found in the house. But he was born in a manger. Amen. And then they give him gifts. They give him the best gifts that they know how to give him, Brother Newton.
Yeah.
But amen, we've got a gift that we can offer him today, and it's a sacrifice of praise.
Amen.
Amen. The Bible says, if my people, which are called by my name, will humble themselves. Amen. The first thing we've got to do is figure out how to humble ourselves.
Yeah.
Amen. Just let loose the flesh and let God take control. Amen. And we'll find out that we can do things. We can do exploits in God. We can give him the praise that he deserves tonight. It may be the Christmas season to the world. Amen. But to the church, he was born. Amen. And to the church, he did live. He did all the things that the Bible speaks about.
Yeah.
He did those things for our benefit.
Yes.
Amen. There's something real about the Christ.
Yes.
Amen. You can look into the Word of God. Amen. And I believe there's about four different Jesuses that you can find in the King James Version Bible. But there was only one Jesus, Christ, the anointed one. Amen. That's the one that we're worshiping and we're praising today. It's not the Judas or the Jesuses of the world. Amen. Because the Jesuses of this world will let us down. But we're serving a Jesus that he won't let us down.
Amen.
I was talking to Brother Newton before church about marriage. Amen. And marriage is something that's honorable in the sight of God. But we're living in a world, amen, that people just want to shack up. They just want to live together. But you know, according to the Word of God, marriage is honorable.
Yeah.
But you know, there's a lot of people in the religious world, they're shacking up with Jesus. That's what they think they're doing. Amen. But if you think about it, if you've taken his name on, amen, you're married to him. You belong to him.
Amen.
Amen. Marriage is honorable. Amen. And the Bible says, and I believe it's in the book of Ephesians, it says, husbands, love your wives as Christ has loved the church. Amen. You think about how much Christ loved the church tonight. Amen. He loved the church so much that he laid his life down for it.
Amen, brother.
Amen. That's how much he loved the church.
Yeah,
all right. And I thought about this week, and I never much thought about this in my life, Sister Newton. But a husband and a wife, amen, when they go through life, they go through life hand in hand. Amen. It's not one stepping in front of the other, or one following the other 10 or 15 feet behind them saying yes sir, no sir, and all that stuff. But it's walking together through life as a unit, as one in Christ. Amen. He looks at us sometimes as one too. Amen. We heard some things preached here Sunday night about the oneness of God. God is one. Don't get beside yourself. God is one. Amen. But there's understanding the mysteries of God is hard for a lot of people to understand. Well, how can God be one when he's the Father, he's the Son, and he's the Holy Ghost? But we can understand that thing if we'll search into the Scriptures. The Bible says, search the Scriptures, for in them ye think ye have eternal life, but they are they which testify of me. Amen. Jesus, if we begin to read on down here in the 7th chapter, I believe it is, amen, where we was reading there, amen, Jesus begins to talk about Moses, how that Moses had written in the law the things concerning Christ. Amen. And Christ come along, amen, and he fulfilled the prophecies that Moses had prophesied. Amen. Every one of the prophets of old, they prophesied about the Messiah, about a way of escape.
Yeah. Amen.
No matter what we see, well, you know, a lot of people see a lot of different things, but if we can just see Jesus. If we can just see Jesus.
Yes. Amen.
Because the Bible says he is the way. He is the truth. He is the life. He came into the world to save sinners.
Yes. Amen.
No matter how, you know, sometimes our puny ideas. We've all got puny ideas. I don't care who we are. I don't care how big a preacher you are or how big a saint you are. We've all got our ideas, our theologies, our philosophies. The Bible says our vain deceit. When we're led after the traditions of men. But I don't want to follow the traditions of men. I want to get into the Word of God and I want to see the truth. Because one thing about it, I want to make it, no matter if nobody else makes it or not, Brother Dude, I want to make it.
Yeah.
Amen. And I, There's a, I think I've got it hanging on the organ. It's called Footprints in the Sand. Amen. Jesus, He